blast injury is a unique form of brain injury in that it has a lot of different levels to it. First of all is the obvious explosive effect of the repercussive pressure wave that comes and passes through the tissue. And, you know, human tissue is has a fluid base to it. So there are effects that happen at a cellular level when these pressure waves, which include the intensive hyperpressurization and then the negative pressure wave afterwards, come through the system. But what makes blast injury different is that often it's accompanied by a series of things. For example, people more often than not are at risk of being hit by flying debris, shrapnel, other projectiles, so they may have a penetrating wound. Often they're knocked through the air or off of what they were standing on, so they would also have the concussive fall effect potentially from then striking their head when they landed. In many instances, the explosive force then has gases or smoke that are released, so you get the anoxic effect from inhaling that and losing oxygen. And then you have all kinds of other sequelae that can come from it. So it's a complex form of injury, and because we're more often than not seeing it in a major accident or far more often now in the context of war, it's often accompanied by psychological trauma, not just the physical trauma. So the TBI, PTSD relationship with the post-traumatic stress disorder is something that's also given consideration.